Okay, so let me be honest here. This video might make you feel a little uncomfortable because we are going to discuss a deeper and a darker side of human mind, which makes us a little evil. If you have ever felt really excited to go and see two people fighting in your neighborhood, or if you felt good after a bike that was overtaking you fell down or got caught by your police, then you will understand what I'm trying to tell. These are just some basic experiences, but if things really get out of hand, people can become somebody who like bullying other people, or people start planning to bring others down so that they can feel good. Through this video, I wanted to discuss two things. The first thing is that I want to share about my understanding of the human mind and behavior so that you can understand how our mind operates and how it leads to the behavioral changes and our behavior in general. And the second purpose of this video is to help you understand the behavior so that you can start focusing on yourself and stop focusing on the other people, which is really important to have the mental clarity and a good mental health. So let's get started with the video. The feeling of satisfaction that we have when we see somebody else's misfortune actually has a name, and that is called Schadenfreude. In order to understand the science behind Schadenfreude, we need to understand these three parts of our brain. The first part of the brain is the ventral striatum, and this is the reward center of the mind. You will understand it better if I say that this region is responsible for the dopamine production. So this part is responsible for making us feel good about something. And the second part of the mind, anterior insula and anterior cingulate cortex, is responsible for empathy. So whenever we feel bad by seeing somebody else in pain, this is the part of the mind that gets activated. And the third part of the brain that we need to understand in order to understand Schadenfreude is prefrontal cortex. And this part of the brain is responsible for reasoning and thinking whether something is right or wrong. Now, depending on the seriousness of the situation and an individual's personality, one of these regions gets activated when we see others in pain. If somebody fell down in front of us, it's not a very serious situation, right? So it's very likely that the ventral striatum gets activated and we laugh at it. But if we saw somebody losing a family member and feeling very sad about it, then there is no way we will feel good about it, right? So in this situation, the anterior insula and the anterior cingulate cortex gets activated, and that's where we feel empathetic about that person, about the other person. Prefrontal cortex, the part that is responsible for reasoning, makes the decision whether it's something that we need to laugh at or it's something that we need to show empathy about. People who have strong emotional intelligence normally tend to have a higher level of empathy too, which means that even when they feel a hint of pleasure when they find somebody in misfortune, they catch themselves up quickly and then choose to feel compassionate for them. Now, the question is, do you have emotional intelligence strong enough to feel compassionate for others and keep yourself in others' shoes? Or are you secretly rooting for somebody else's failure? There can be a couple of reasons why we secretly may want others to fail. The first reason is power dynamics and survival. If we get back to the ancient time, fights and wars, they were a very important part of life, even for survival. And it was necessary for us to win the opponent and beat them or see them lose so that we get that power. And it was also necessary to get the resources like food and water because they were very limited. And even now, our mind is still stuck at the scarcity mindset. But it's very high time we realize that right now, it's time we get the abundance mindset, which means that the other person can win and I can win too, because the resources are unlimited now. Even the opportunities are unlimited. So it's very important for us to understand that we all can win, and it's not necessary for the other person to lose or die or get into pain for us to succeed. The second reason why we enjoy some specific people failing or getting into pain is because we believe that they deserve it. Remember the example of the motorbike that I gave you in the first half of the video, where we secretly enjoy a motorbike falling down if they were speeding, then we feel that it's because of their karma, their bad deeds. And we believe that it's justice, it's fair, and they got what they deserved. This is the same reason why we really enjoy a villain or a bully getting beaten up in a movie. Now, the third reason why we secretly enjoy the failures of others is because of envy and rivalry. No matter how much we deny it, but we are always in a secret competition with people around us, because that's how we measure the level of our success and failure. So whenever we see somebody else failing, we believe that even though they were moving ahead in life, now we are on the same pace, and that's what triggers the reward system. So what's the solution now? How do we deal with Schadenfreude and how to increase our emotional intelligence and also be more empathetic? Let's discuss the most effective solutions now. The first one is awareness without shame and without judgment. Whenever you feel like you are getting happy or pleased about the misfortune of others, feel that it's okay and it's how our mind is made. So just be more aware about what's going on in our mind. It's the psychology, right? So do not feel guilty about it. Just accept it. The solution starts from acceptance. Now the second solution is empathize with others. Let's say your coworker was expecting a promotion for a very long time and they didn't get it. And now they are upset. Now secretly we may enjoy it because of the psychological competition, but this time choose to step in their shoes, because now you are aware what's happening in your mind, right? So try to stick to their shoes and try to feel for them, because when we are aware about the problem, we can use our prefrontal cortex, we can use our reasoning to distinguish what's wrong and what's right. So the next time, try to be aware about what's happening to your mind and just try to be empathetic for the other person. And it's a practice. We get better, we get strong mentally, and we feel happier when we use such practice. And this is how we can actually start focusing on our life and stop feeling good about the failures of others. That's all for today, and stay connected with me by subscribing to the channel. Have a nice time.